Crews in northeastern Japan have been working almost nonstop over the past 10 months, removing rubble, repairing buildings, and putting up new structures. But the March 11th earthquake and tsunami did not just wreck infrastructure. It also put countless cultural assets at risk. Saving these national treasures is proving to be a difficult job, as we find out in this week's Road Ahead. NHK World's Daiichi Takahashi shows us.
Hidefumi Sanpei is the Tomioka Town Curator in Fukushima Prefecture. Tomioka is in the no-entry zone, which was created after the nuclear crisis. The town government has a makeshift office in another municipality outside the zone. Sanpei has been trying to raise awareness about the value of cultural assets for many years. But the problem is that no one knows for sure the extent of the damage. Municipal authorities haven't even been able to salvage some of the items. Sanpei conducted the survey last November to gauge the situation.
People who run the museum are now discussing how to move the cultural treasures out of the building.
A water leak has caused mold on the ceiling. The excess moisture is making the situation worse for preserving the artifacts. Sanpei noticed broken fragments of ancient earthenware that are about 5,000 years old. The temperature control has not been working because of a power outage. Ancient documents and other invaluable assets may be damaged. They will have to be removed immediately. Sanpei and his survey team couldn't stay long enough to move them due to high radiation levels in the area.
Cultural assets represent our regional history. They should be passed on to future generations and preserved to serve as a bond for the community.
Meanwhile, another town has managed to recover their cultural assets but is facing difficulty.
You can see the tsunami damage here.
The tsunami devastated the cultural center in Ishinomaki, Miyagi Prefecture. The center was home to over 100,000 regional artifacts. The items were recovered from the mud, but now the challenge is organizing them. Sadly, the tsunami left some cultural center employees missing. It also washed away the catalogs. A fresh endeavor is now underway to put the recovered items in order. Thanks to a local printing factory, about 3,000 cultural assets from the Ishinomaki Center are being stored there. Work is also in progress to catalog them.
We're making a new catalog. The new data will help curators in their research and restoration work.
The Ishinomaki government plans to collect the items that are being kept at various locations across the country and put them on display again.
Not just a year or two. It will take several years. Reconstruction from the disaster won't be completed until the cultural assets have been restored.